Hi everyone, in this video, we're going to be deriving the conservation of mass equations, also known as the continuity equation, in rectangular coordinates. We will be doing this through a Eulerian approach, which means that our control volume will be at one specific position and not move, and we will view the fluids passing through our control volume. Alright, so let's get right into this derivation. Let's begin by drawing our control volume, which for rectangular coordinates will just be a simple box. Our control volume is fully enclosed by our fluid. The faces of our control volume are called the control surfaces. The fluid will be entering and exiting all these control surfaces at some rate. So, to better understand this, let's write the general conservation equation, which is the accumulation within our control volume is equal to the rate of the mass entering our control volume minus the rate of the mass leaving our control volume plus any generation within the control volume, minus any mass consumed within our control volume. Let's assume that we do not have any reactions in this equation, therefore our generation and consumption terms will both be zero. So, the only way we are going to have accumulation in this control volume is if the mass coming into our control volume is greater than the mass leaving our control volume. And this should make sense, right? All right. Let's look at the mass entering our control surface at y1. The mass entering this face is going to equal the mass flux, units of kilogram per meter squared per second, times the control surface area, which is the size of our box in both the x and z direction, as you can see here. So, through only looking in the y direction, this is our rate of mass in. Similarly, the rate of mass out in our y direction is going to be the following, which is the same except the velocity is identified at the outlet y control surface. So, that was the balance of mass and only in our y direction. However, we can do the exact same thing in both the x and z directions. And I've presented that here for you. So, we now have general equations for the rate of mass into and out of our control volume for the x, y, and z directions. We are now only missing the general equation for the rate of accumulation before we can fully solve for the continuity equation. So, we are looking for the change in mass within our control volume over time. However, let's remember that mass can also be written as density times a volume. So, let's substitute that in. And also, since we stated earlier that our control volume is constant, we know that it will not be changing with time, and we are left with the following equation. Therefore, we are now able to substitute in our three general equations we found for the accumulation, the rate of mass in, and the rate of mass out. Now all that is left to do is divide the right side of our equation by the size of our control volume and set the limit for all sides of our control volume to zero. The reason we do this is because it allows us to understand the density change at one specific point. If this is still confusing to you, I recommend you check out the continuum assumption video, for which I will leave a link in the description below for your better understanding. Alright, so now we are left with the following equation, which, as we just stated, is a change in density at one specific point in our fluid. We now rearrange it so that we are going to equal zero, since we know that there could be no creation or destruction of mass. These changes occur due to the mass velocity vector term here. A mass velocity vector has the same units as flux, but since it is a vector, it has both magnitude and directions. So, we are basically saying we have so much mass, m, traveling some direction at some velocity v. This upside down triangle here is called the gradient, del, or nabla. All three names mean the same thing. This is just a way of making our equations more concise and look better. All it means is that we are taking the derivative of this right term here in all three spatial directions. So, another way of writing del mass velocity vector is like so. If we know that our accumulation term is going to be zero, then the following simplification can be made. This term here will go to zero, and nabla, mass velocity vector, is going to be your only term, which remember, we could write out like so. So, in summary, we can write out our continuity equation as either of the following, as they are the same thing. Just as a final note, we typically use these rectangular coordinates for one-dimensional problems, In the following two videos, we will go through the derivation of the continuity equation for both cylindrical and spherical coordinates. Cylindrical coordinates are commonly used for 2D problems, and lastly, spherical coordinates are used mostly for 3D problems. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about how we arrive at the continuity equation in rectangular coordinates in transport phenomena. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and check out our Patreon page to support our channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.